Hello student, in this video we are going to start the topic pollination. In the last video we had discussed about male and female gametophyte. Now pollination means transfer of pollen grain. We know that pollen grain microspore is a partially developed male gametophyte. Inside this anther, pollen grain undergo first mitosis and become biceled structure. That biceled pollen grain release out from the anther, and with the help of some external agencies, this pollen grain is deposited on the stigma. Stigma is a receptive part of the carpel. So this transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma is referred as pollination. The process of pollination was first discovered by the scientist Camerarius in 1964. So pollination, let's suppose this is a bilobed anther. After dehiscence of this anther, biceled pollen grain released and deposited on the topmost part of the carpel, that is the stigma. However, the pollen grain is non-motile because it does not have the flagella. It is non-flagellated. That's why pollen grain by itself cannot be moved on the stigma, since it does not have the flagella. Therefore, some external agencies are required which help pollen grain to transfer on the stigma. So this process of transfer is known as pollination. Now this pollination is again mainly classified into two types. The first type of pollination is known as self-pollination, and another type is known as cross type of pollination. In self-pollination, only single plant body is involved. However, cross-pollination involved two different plant bodies. So cross-pollination is also known as allogamy. Self-pollination, which involves single plant body, this self-pollination is again classified into two types. The first type, in which pollination occurs within a single flower of a plant, is known as autogamy. Auto means self, and here gamy word is derived from the Greek language gamos, which means the marriage. So autogamy is a pollination which not only takes place on a single plant but also occur within a single flower. So autogamy occur in single flower of single plant. So there are several conditions to occur autogamy. Success of pollination is occur when pollen grain deposited on stigma, and this deposited pollen grain get germinated. So germination of pollen grain is necessary for successfulness of the pollination. Here autogamy having several essential conditions for pollination. For example, the autogamous flower, the flower which show the autogamy, is called as autogamous flower. So autogamous flower must be bisexual, means flower have both reproductive organ, microsporophyll and megasporophyll, that is stamen as well as carpel. And second important thing is that both stamen and carpel should have to mature at the same time. So time period of maturity of both stamen and carpel is known as homogamy. So homogamy is a necessary condition beside the bisexual flower. Third condition, if flower, there are some plants in which clistogamous flower are present. Clistogamous flower means the flower which never open, and in most of the cases clistogamous flower is present in underground part of the plant body. So some plant having the clistogamous flower, I am writing here the name of plants in which clistogamous flower are present below the soil, and normal flowers are chasmogamous flower, which are also present but on aerial part of the plant body. The example of clistogamous flower are viola, commelina bengalensis, erachis hypogea, erachis hypogea. So these are the examples of those plants which have the clistogamous type of flower. So as the flower never open, but this is bisexual and homogamous flower, so it should have to perform only self-pollination, that is autogamy type of pollination. However, this plant also have the aerial flower which show the normal opening, and normal openable flower are known as chasmogamous flower. Chasmogamous flower which show normal opening. So this is the autogamy. And in autogamy, when pollen grain are transferred from anther to stigma of the same parental plant body, so male gamete and female gamete have the similar genetic material. After formation of zygote and seed, in the seed, which is a result of autogamy, this seed does not have variable genetic material. So there is a surety of pure genetic material in a seed which is developed after the autogamy. So after the autogamy, the next type of pollination which included in the self type is known as geitonogamy. First one is autogamy and second one is geitonogamy. In case of geitonogamy, pollination occur in between two different flowers which are born on same plant body. Same plant body. But in geitonogamy, pollinating agent is required. And if pollinating agent is required, the pollination is known as cross type of pollination. However, the pollination taking place on a single plant body, it included in the self type of pollination. So geitonogamy, we can state here more clearly, geitonogamy is partially cross-pollination and partially self-pollination. That is, if genetic material does not change, single parental plant body having similar genetic material in pollen grain, that is inside the male gamete as well as female gamete, so due to no variation in a genetic material, geitonogamy is known as self-pollination. Self-pollination due to uncontamination of genetic material. But for transporting of pollen grain from one flower to other flower, pollinating agent is required. That's why on the basis of pollinating agent, geitonogamy is known as cross-pollination. So several examples you can take here. Geitonogamy, for example, cucurbits. In cucurbits, geitonogamy occur. So geitonogamy is functionally cross-pollination and genetically self-pollination. We can take another example of Cleistocampus flower is Oxalis. Oxalis reniculata. So four examples are essential according to the lead point of view for Cleistocampus flower. Examples are Viola, Comelina, RHS and Oxalis reniculata. The second type of pollination is cross-pollination. And this cross-pollination is also known as allogeny, the transfer of pollen grain from anther of a flower which is borne on a one plant body to another flower which is borne on another plant body. So here pollination taking place in between two different plant body, that's why it is called as cross pollination. And another reason to say it as a cross pollination is involvement of pollinating agent. So this cross pollination is a distance traveling of the pollen grain. Cross pollination occur in two different plants. Cross pollination again classify into two types. If two plants are belonging to the same species, two plants are of same species, then this type of cross pollination is known as xenogamy. Example of xenogamy is papaya. This papaya, botanical name is Carica papaya. So this papaya is a dioecious plant. Male plant and female plant are different. Pollination occurring between two different plants, but both plants belong to same species. That's why it is called as xenogamy. In another type, let's suppose pollination occur between two different plants and both the plants belong to different species. The type of pollination is called as hybridization. And this hybridization is commonly not successful type of pollination because incompatible pollen grain deposited on the stigma. So we can consider the example of hybridization is cotton. So in cotton, hybridization type of cross pollination takes place. In papaya, xenogamy type of cross pollination takes place. So this is all about the pollination and its type. Now in the next video, we are discussing the different pollinating agents.